Hey y'all, I'm Corey Ashton, and it is another exciting WordPress Wednesday today. We're going to continue our series on gravity forms. Hold on. You can probably hear me better if I actually use the darn microphone. All right. We're going to continue our series on gravity forms. I've already done a basic install and a basic, you know, how to add a field. We're going to go even more advanced today. We're going to talk specifically about how to style your gravity forms, because out of the box, it looks nice. But your theme could apply some weird wonkiness effects to it, and you have some potential to really kind of get fancy with it and set it up in a better flow. So we're going to talk really briefly about my awesome sponsors that I have sitting here. We've got, of course, our amazing partner in hosting is WP Engine. They offer incredible WordPress hosting. We've got WP Elevation. If you're an entrepreneur using WordPress as a freelancer or in your business, please check out their tracks. You're going to get inspired and find some really cool resources for you. And of course, WP 101. You've got more WordPress tutorial videos, so you've got to get over there and check them out. They're amazing. All right, let's talk about it. Gravity forms. Let's see. Let me get rid of that. Okay, so we are talking about gravity forms, all right? And we're moving on now to the second video in our series of six. I'm gonna do six videos. It's crazy. We're gonna talk next about how to set up all of your notifications with some really cool dynamic stuff. After that, we're gonna be talking about conditional logic. That's cool. We're gonna go into add-ons and talk about all the different options that you can, for free, throw in some add-ons, and then we're also going to talk about how to use it as some sort of a very minimal style store, or potentially even a registration form, something comparable to like Eventbrite. You guys could be using that here and not losing all those fees. You could actually be using gravity forms to do stuff like that. So stick around. Be sure to click the subscribe button right down here so that you're able to catch all these videos every single week. All right, moving into styling. How do we do it? Last video, one of the things I didn't show you is if you needed to reorder these, all you simply do is grab and drag and drop them, right? So that's a little bit of styling where you can grab and drag and drop. Each individual field has options. You just click on your little arrow, open it up, and you can see some of the different options. There's even an appearance tab where you can place different things. If you hover over these little question marks, they'll give you a little bit more involved description of what this particular input field or option has available to you, okay? So I want to show you what this form looks like on our website. You'll see here a name, first name, last name, company name, title, email, phone. So let's go here. You're going to see first name, last name, company name, your title, email, and phone. I'm going to slide off screen so you can see this full width area. I do have the style of my page set to full width. So you can see this form is really kind of ginormous. And we know, let me click a refresh here because let's do this, refresh. Actually, yeah, so company name is sitting across here, full width. It's kind of ridiculous. Hopefully nobody's company name is that ginorma. And then you've got your title, which is huge as well. What if we wanted to style these where potentially company name would take up the same space as first, and maybe we could bring your title up here and have it in kind of a two-column setting, just like first and last name. How would we be able to do that? That's actually something out of the box you can adjust with gravity forms. So it's just kind of extra that if you didn't know, or you didn't do a whole lot of research, or you didn't know what to even call it, you probably wouldn't be able to find it. It's a little tricky. So I'm going to walk you through that. So I want company name to be on the left side of the screen, and then I want your title to slide up here and be sitting on the right side of the screen, right? So how do we make that happen? I am going to open this up, and I'm going to go to appearance. I'm going to go to this custom CSS class, okay? This is something that if you already know how to write nerd code and CSS and you really wanted to give this form a completely different look, a background color, or maybe this particular field right here, this company name, you wanted to give it some sort of standout pop color or anything you wanted to do to it. If you know how to write nerd code, you could manually go into your style sheet, write that nerd code, and then assign the class here. But Gravity Forms actually has things assigned already. You just might not know about them, right? So we're going to say GF for gravity form, and we're going to say left half. You see what I'm typing in there? GF for gravity form, the underscore, the word left, underscore, the word half. I'm going to zip that box back up. I'm going to come here to your title. Now this one under appearance, I want it to go on the right side, correct? So I'm going to say GF for gravity forms, and I'm going to assign right underscore half, okay? And then I'm going to go ahead and click update form, slide off the screen here for you, come back to the front side of our website. I'm going to click refresh, and now our company name is sitting here nice on the left side. Your title is sitting here perfectly on the right side with a nice little description below it, but I think this kind of opens up too much of a gap. So what if we were to put it, well, you can put it above or below. It's up to you. Or we can just remove it completely, right? So those options would be individually right here in this space. I typed that part in. So we can either remove it, or if you wanted to put it above, you can choose the option for above inputs, and it would place it directly above the input area. All right? Pretty cool there. I know. So let's talk about what if we wanted to have a totally different color. Or maybe we want to put a background color, like I was saying earlier, and you don't know. What if you don't know CSS? So how do you make that happen? There are actually all sorts of options for styling your gravity forms over in a premium version over here on Code Canyon. You can go through here and see all the different options, add-ons for gravity forms. One of the first ones that I found that I liked was this gravity form styler. It is a little pricey. It's $33, but apparently it does some really cool stuff. They've got a video preview here that you can click on and see exactly what all it does. But you can see that you can do all sorts of changes just with a drag and drop environment, and you don't necessarily have to have coding capabilities, and you're able to change the color of text fields, the color of the background, how wide the boxes are, if they have a border around them, the font, all sorts of funness. So you can kind of play around with that for $33, or just kind of sift through here with Code Canyon and see what all is available for add-ons. There's also, of course, free options. You can go through the plugin directory and see all the different add-ons. The only thing that's really costly initially is that purchase of Gravity Forms, because it's a premium plugin, right? So if you're wondering how to make more column options and do other things that I've already mentioned in this tutorial, I'm gonna put a link in the description box below. There's this page here. Let me back up one link, and I'll put both of these links in the description box below. Gravity Forms has some pretty great documentation. Let me slide down just a little bit here. You'll see it on their website. You can come here and you wanna click CSS Ready Classes. Clicking that link takes you into all sorts of examples of what you can be adding into this custom filled class area. So it gives you your left half, your right half, that's for two columns. It gives you the option to do a middle third so that you can have three columns, one, two, three, and section things out that way. You can make them go in line, so you can use this and kind of see what that plays around with. All sorts of different options here. So I mean this lines them up beautifully here for a three column list. That's beautiful. You can do all sorts of fun stuff like that with these pre-made classes, okay? So I'm gonna put that link in the description box below. The other thing I wanna tell you before I let you go is one other setting that if you miss this, this could actually have errors on your website or potential breaks. So once you've already created your form and you see it on the front side of your website, if it looks a little wonky or things aren't really looking exactly the way you want them to, you could come do a test and see there's a settings area underneath forms. Go to settings. This is not for the individual form. So under, let me back up for a second. Under every form, you have a settings. I don't want you to go to individual forms. I need you to go to the super settings area here that affects all of your gravity forms at once, okay? If you go to the settings area, I want you to see about this area right here. It says output CSS and output HTML5. You might want to just play around with these two settings. Set one to no, go down and click save, and then refresh your page. I'm going to do that right now just to let you see. It kind of goes wonky, and it actually starts adding bullet points, which is like an ordered list to my form. So if your form looks like this and you're thinking, oh man, that looks horribly wrong, maybe you need to go into your settings here and check yes and allow the output CSS to be there so that when I come back and click refresh, now it's purdy again, right? It's purdy. Things aren't too wonky there. So that's some ideas there. You can also play around with this setting here with HTML5 and see how that affects things. You might have to do some other settings as well, and you'll want to follow the author's instructions if you do purchase one of these forms. I believe this one requires that you enable Ajax for the styling to work. So just a heads up on that. Anyway, I hope this was very helpful to you. If you have questions, please go ahead and comment in the box below. Next week, we are moving on to how to set up your notifications, because you absolutely want people, as soon as they click submit, you want people to get a notification in their inbox, and you want to receive notification as well. There's possibilities, get this, you guys, there are possibilities to send notifications to different people on your team, depending upon what the choices were inside the dropdown. There's also opportunities to automatically send maybe a PDF. So let's say you're offering, hey, if you want to sign up today for this, you instantly get a free PDF on how to do X, Y, and Z, right? You create that PDF, add it as an attachment inside of that notification area, and it goes out without you having to mess with it one bit. Isn't that incredible? I'll teach you how to do that next WordPress Wednesday. Be sure to subscribe right here. See you then. Bye-bye, y'all.